So I'll first prove this theorem without wasting any more time. So I hope the statement was very much clear to you. So I am assuming that this limit is L. I have to prove that for any function phi having limit at x tends to a to be b, this limit will be L again. Okay. So the idea of proof being very simple, I'll just use the definition of this limit and definition of limit for single variable. Okay, so I'll just use the definitions and get my answer. So let me do it very quickly.
Okay,
so proof. Okay, so what's the proof? So first of all, let me choose any number epsilon arbitrarily which is greater than 0. Okay, since they have given limit x comma y tends to a comma b of the function fx y is L, so therefore for the chosen epsilon greater than 0, there exists a delta positive, you know, I'm choosing delta to be delta 1. Just apply the definition of this limit. So if this limit is L, for this chosen epsilon, there exists a delta positive. I'm choosing the delta to be delta 1. So there exists a delta 1 positive such that what happens, you know, for all x comma y inside D in the domain satisfying I'm taking the rectangular neighborhood, not the circular one, satisfying 0 less than x minus a, as you can see here, x minus a less than delta 1 and 0 less than y minus b less than delta 1 implies modulus of fxy minus L is less than epsilon. Suppose this is some equation 1. I have just used the definition of limit. You know, whenever this limit is L for some chosen number epsilon, you will always find some delta such that for all x comma y and d, you may take a circular neighborhood of a comma b, or you may also take a square neighborhood of a comma b. I am choosing the square one. Okay, as you can say, this is a square neighborhood. So this happens. Again, what else is given to us? What else is also given to us? Also, since you know this limit is given to us to be, this limit is given to us as b, right? This limit is given to us as b. You may check the statement. So again, use the definition that you have done in analysis, right? This is the limit of the single variable. So what is the definition? Therefore, for the chosen number, the chosen number I'll take this term to be delta 1. Okay, here is only the catch that this is true for any epsilon greater than 0. You will find some delta and under which the condition will be satisfied, you know. But instead of choosing this number, I'll choose this number. So for the chosen delta 1, there exists some number delta 2 such that, what is the definition of here? So for all x belonging to the domain of phi, d of phi means domain of phi, right? Satisfying, you know, just look at the definition of a limit for a single variable. Satisfying 0 less than, the point is a, so x minus a less than delta 2, it will imply modulus of phi x minus b is less than epsilon. Epsilon here is delta 1. I hope you remember the epsilon delta definition in terms of single variable, and it's more or less same as you can see. Just here, this condition will not be there because there is only one variable we are talking about. So this is some equation 2. Okay. Now you see, I will replace this delta 1 and delta 2. I'll replace this delta 1 and delta 2 by their minimum. So call delta to be minimum of delta 1 comma delta 2, then both of these conditions will hold, right? For delta equals to for delta. So if I choose delta to be minimum of these two quantities, this statement 1 and this statement 2, I'll rewrite, replacing all the delta 1s and delta 2s by delta. So then from 1 and 2 we get, so try to understand my point, we get, this is 1 and this is 2, right? So from 1 and 2 we get, for all x comma y in B satisfying 0 less than x minus a less than delta, I should write actually this one, for a chosen. So we get, for any epsilon positive, or the chosen epsilon positive, this was already chosen here. So for chosen epsilon positive, for all x comma y satisfying this delta, instead of writing delta, I'll write delta, and 0 less than y minus b less than delta implies fxy minus l is less than epsilon, and for all x in domain of phi satisfying 0 less than x minus a less than delta implies modulus of phi x minus b is less than delta. So my point is, I have rewritten statements 1 and statement 2, just replacing all the delta 1s and delta 2s by delta. Delta is minimum of these two, so both the statements will hold. So this is our first statement, this is my second statement, right? Just see here, what does the first statement tells you? You choose any ordered pair from D satisfying this condition. This x coordinate satisfies this condition and the y coordinate satisfies this condition. Am I clear? So then this will happen. Now my point is, phi x will satisfy this condition. If you choose y to be phi x, then this condition is satisfied. Do you agree with me? Because if I write phi x here instead of y, what I have? 0 less than phi x minus b less than delta, which is true. So did you get my point? So what can I guarantee? That phi, this point x comma phi x is inside this domain satisfying this condition. Did you understand or no? If I am writing here phi x instead of y, this condition is satisfied. Why this is satisfied? Just because of this. I know phi x minus b is actually less than delta. So I have this pair x comma phi x inside D satisfying this condition. 0 less than x minus a less than delta and 0 less than phi x minus b less than delta. Yes or no? Understood? Why this point is this? X comma phi x is inside D satisfying this condition. Do you all agree? Or no? Be very honest. So whenever I have this point in D satisfying this condition, what can I say then? This will hold. Therefore, modulus of phi f x comma y. Y is what? Phi x. minus n is less than epsilon for all x, for all x belonging to domain of phi satisfying 0 less than x minus a less than delta. See, from this statement and this statement, I am concluding this last line. How? Whenever I have x from here, I have the guarantee that this will be less than delta. So when this is satisfied, this is automatically satisfied for phi x. And because these two are together satisfied for x comma phi x, then f of x comma phi x minus L will be less than epsilon. This is what I have written. This is less than epsilon for all x satisfying this. Because whenever this condition is satisfied, this condition automatically gets satisfied. So I can just write this. So from the definition of limit of single variable, you see, for any epsilon greater than 0, f of x, this is now just a function of x, remember that. So f of x minus l is less than epsilon for all x satisfying this condition. By the definition of limit of single variable, what can I say? The limit of this function at a is l. So what I'll write then, therefore limit of this function x comma phi x as x tends to a is nothing but l, and this completes the proof of the theorem. This is what I was supposed to prove. So remember that this theorem will not help us for finding the limit, but rather this function will be like this theorem will be used for showing that limits, some limits does not exist. How can you do that? If I can find two function phi x for which this limit is the value of this limit is getting different for different phi x, like suppose for some phi x this is coming as l, for some another phi x it is coming as m, and l and m are not different. They are different, I mean, right? Then what can I say? The limit cannot exist. So this is how this theorem will be very much essential. It says that if the limit is L, then for any function phi x, this limit will be L. But if for different functions phi x, I am getting the value of this limit different, I can say that the limit f of x comma y tending to a comma b, does not exist. Don't worry, you'll understand what I'm trying to say. Look at this question. Show that this function, okay, show that this limit x comma y tending to 0 comma 0 x square minus y square by x square plus y square does not exist. This is my question. I want to prove that this limit does not exist. Okay? So you see, as I want to prove that this limit will not exist, what I will do, I'll find two functions phi x for which this limit is coming two different values. In that case, I can say that the limit does not exist. First of all, the domain of this function, you see, here f of x comma y, the function is what? X square minus y square by x square plus y square. Good enough. Okay, I want to find the limit at 0 comma 0, remember that. So I can clearly see the domain of the function is actually whole of R2 except 0 comma 0, because I cannot put both x and y to be 0 simultaneously, and clearly 0 comma 0 is a limit point of domain. So because the domain does not have only one point, so whatever open ball, however small or however big you draw around 0, 0, that will definitely intersect this. That is for sure. Now you see, what I will have to do, I have to find this function phi x, right? So you have to go to this 0, 0 using different paths. Try to understand my point. Here is my point 0, 0. There are many ways to reach this point. I may go about this point, about this path to 0, 0. I may take this path to reach 0, 0. I may take this path to reach 0, 0. I may take this path to reach 0, 0, and so on. What I will do, so let us go about x axis. Let us approach this 0, 0 about the x axis. So if we approach 0, 0 along the x axis, that is y equals to 0, because you know what name this curve can be represented. This curve can be represented by the name y equals to 0. So here the phi x becomes 0 function. If we approach 0, 0, I am approaching 0, 0 with this line. If we approach 0, 0 along the curve x axis, therefore what is my limit? Try to understand my point. Limit, okay, forget about the limit now. What about the function x instead of y? Instead of y, what will I write? I write phi x. What is my phi x? 0. So that means I'll simply write y to be 0. Let us see what this function becomes. In this function, you put y equals to 0. If this equals to 0, this equals to 0. This is 0, this is 0. What I'm getting? X square by x square. Because x is not 0, what I can do? I can cancel them, and this will be simply 1. Or you can write like this only for the time being. X square by x square I'm getting. Suppose I'm writing like this only. Therefore, let us find this limit. Limit x comma y tends to 0, 0. Limit x tends to 0. And by the way, you see, at x tends to 0, this function goes to 0. That should happen. Don't forget that. Let us find this limit x comma 0. What is this? This is limit x tends to 0, x square by x square. This can be cancelled because x is never equal to 0. So what is the value of this limit? I am getting the value of this limit to be 1. If I am approaching through this path, the path y equals to 0, I am getting the limit to be 1. Did you understand this approach or no? You remember, this function should go to 0 as x tends to 0. That was the condition. Okay. You will understand. Don't worry about it. Let me do some more sums. If you are not getting this, you will understand. Okay. So now, let's approach to 0, 0 using different curve. So if we approach 0, 0 along this curve, suppose along the y-axis, what is y-axis? Along this curve. I can also show that using the same reasoning, that this limit y tends to be psi y, y will also be L. Just apply the same concept. Here I am considering y is a function of x. Here I am considering x is a function of y. So this limit will also be L. Okay. So if we approach 0, 0 along the y axis, I am approaching through this. So what will be my function now? Function, instead of x, I will put 0 and y remains y this time. So what will be my function? X is 0, x is 0. This will be minus y square by y square. So what is the limit? So therefore, limit, this time not x tends to 0, this time y tends to 0. Okay, so f of 0 comma y, which is limit y tends to 0 minus y square by y square, because y is not 0, cancelling this, this thing getting minus 1. You see, if I approach this function from this curve, I am getting the limit to be 1, but if I am approaching towards this path from this part at this point, I am getting the limit to be minus 1, which are not equal. So what can I conclude? That the actual limit does not exist. That means this limit cannot exist, because if this would have been exist, then what can I say? If you go along any path, you will get the same answer. Did you understand my point? So, therefore, I can simply say that this limit x comma y tends to 0 comma 0, f of x comma y, which was nothing but x square minus y square by x square plus y square, does not exist. So proved, right? Let me take another question very quickly. So find the limit. Which limit? Limit x comma y tends to 0 comma 0. The function is x square y by x to the power 4 plus y square. This function I have, okay? Yeah. And this function, find the limit this if it exists. I want to find this limit provided the limit exists. If it does not exist, I cannot find this limit. But if it does not exist, you have to give a proper reasoning. So solution will be exactly in the same manner here. Call this function like this, and clearly here also the domain is everything except 0, 0, 0, 0 is the limit point. All those things you may write definitely. So I'm skipping those portions for the time being. I want to approach to 0, 0. So let's start in the same way how we did. So let us approach this way, right? So if we approach 0, 0 along this curve, along x axis, that means along y equals to 0, then what is my function? F of x comma 0, right? So this will become, this is becoming totally 0, because when y is 0, the numerator is getting 0, so this eventually the function will be a 0 function. Then what is this limit? Limit x tends to 0. Why x tends to 0? Due to this. Remember, the curve that you are choosing, that should tend to this number. So as x tends to 0, y tends to 0. Remember that. So I can choose this. You cannot choose the curve y equals to 1. Because when you are choosing y equals to 1, as x tends to 0, this function is not approaching 0. This should approach 0. Keep that in mind. You cannot choose any random curve. So what is this limit I am getting? Because the function is 0, the limit will be 0. And similarly, if we approach 0, 0 along, suppose y axis, right? So here also, as y tends to 0, this should go to 0, this is going to 0, no doubt about it. So what is my function in that case? F of 0 comma y. X is 0, I'll put here x equals to 0. Again, the numerator is getting 0, so this is 0. So what I am getting, this limit y tends to 0, because here the variable is y. So f of 0 comma y, what I am getting, this also 0. So this time If I am approaching 0, 0 using this path, and using this path, I am getting the same answer. But this is not enough to conclude that the limit is 0. Remember that you checked for this too, and you are getting 0, 0, and you can conclude that no. So what will be the answer? The limit will be 0. The limit is existing. You have to check for all possible paths. If these two are coming different, you can simply conclude that the limit does not exist. But if these two are coming same, you cannot conclude that the limit is 0. This is just two paths. You have to check for all possible paths. Did you understand my point? Now you see, we are stuck in the middle. Like, I cannot even conclude that the limit does not exist, and I cannot even say that the limit is 0. I will choose some another path. Suppose I am choosing this line to approach 0, 0. Suppose I am choosing this line to approach 0, 0. Or I am choosing this line to approach 0, 0. So in general, what is the equation of this line? They are of the form y equals to mx. Because they are passing through the origin, so the y-intercept part will be 0. So it will be of the form yx plus 0. So I'm going to write this. So remember this. Any line, if I am approaching to 0, 0 using any of these brown lines, in general, their equation is y equals to mx. Let's see what happens if I put it here. Okay, so let me write that. So if we approach 0, 0 along this curve. Now remember, you just check, can I take this curve? Yes, I can take this curve. Why? When x tends to 0, this will go to 0. So because the limit as x tends to 0, y should go to 0. Keep that in mind. I can choose this path. Why can I choose this path? Because as x tends to 0, this will be going to 0. So what is my function in that case? Then f of x remains x, instead of y I'll write mx. Let's see this. In the numerator, what I will do is, instead of x I will put x, instead of y I'll put mx. So this will become x square. So x square will remain x square, and y will become mx. In the denominator, what will I get? X to the power 4 plus y square. What is y square? M square x square. What I am getting? Mx cube. Just a minute. Yeah. I am getting mx cube, and from the denominator, x square is common. I am cancelling that x. So I'll get x by x square plus m square. Assuming that x is not 0 definitely. So what is my limit therefore? My limit as x tends to 0. What is the limit of this function at x tends to 0? Definitely as x tends to 0, this is also going 0. Did you understand? Because as x tends to 0, you put 0 here. Numerator is 0, but denominator is m square, so which may not be 0. So eventually it is going to 0. So this limit will be 0. Again the same thing. If I am approaching to 0, 0, taking any line, either any line, like this will also include these two lines as well, basically. Okay. Now you see, if I am approaching to 0, 0 using any of these lines, brown lines or this purple ones, then also I am getting the answer to be 0. So now you might be thinking, okay sir, let's conclude that the limit exists and the limit is 0. Because I have taken all possible paths. No, the answer is a complete no. I have not taken all possible paths. I have many other paths. These are just straight lines. I can take any curve also. I can take this curve to reach 0, 0. I may use this parabola to reach 0, 0. So let's take this parabola to reach 0, 0. So what is the equation of a parabola in simple? Like simple equation is y equals to x square. Okay? So let's see what happens if you go up, to 0, 0 using this parabola. So what is the equation of a general parabola? You know, in the standard form it is y equals to 4ax square, right? But forget about this, sorry, not this one. You know why, sorry. X square equals to 4ay. Anyways, both are same thing more or less. So my point is, let's go to using this parabola and see what happens. Let's see what happens. So this time we will approach 0, 0. So if we approach 0, 0 along this curve, along y equals to x square, which is the parabola, and you just check again, as x tends to 0, will this function go to 0? The answer is yes. The answer is yes, because at 0, this function goes to 0, right? If you approach along this curve, then what is my function? Function was x comma y. Instead of y, what I'll write? X square. What was my function? Function was x square y by x to the power 4 plus y square. This was the function, right? So instead of x, I'll keep x. Instead of y, I'll put x square. X to the power 4 plus y square. X to the power 4. What am I getting? X to the power 4 by 2x to the power 4. Assuming x to be not 0, I'm getting 1 by 2. This is different. This limit x tends to 0, f of x comma x square, this limit I am getting half. Now you see what I can conclude. If I am going to 0, 0 along any line, my answer was going to 0. My answer was 0. The limit value was 0. But if I am going to 0, 0 along this parabola, my limit is half. So along any line my answer is 0, but along this parabola my answer is half. That means the limit cannot exist, because if the limit would exist, then the answer would also come 0 in this case also, right? So what can I conclude? So therefore, this limit, you may justify why this limit does not exist, because if you approach 0, 0 along the curve y equals to mx, I'm getting the limit to be 0, but if I'm approaching towards through this curve, I'm getting half. So in that case, this limit x square y by x to the power 4 plus y square, this limit does not exist. So you see, this is the reason I told you that this theorem will not be helpful to determine the limit, because it is not possible to cover all possible paths. But this theorem will be helpful for determining which limit exists and which limit does not exist. Okay, so this is what is important. Did you get my point? I'll give you some homeworks to do later on in the group, maybe I'll send. So my only thing is of consideration is, suppose x comma y tends to 1 comma 2, I have some function. If I ask you to prove that this limit does not exist, you will consider all possible paths. Now you will tell, sir, we will always start with the path x equals to 0 and y equals to 0. I will say no. Why? This time you cannot reach 1 comma 2. Can you reach 1 comma 2 using this path? Not at all. You cannot reach 1 comma 2 using this path. So this is the reason I told you, you have to go to this point. You cannot take this path to reach this point. If you are taking this path, y equals to 0, you see, as x tends to 1, is this function going to 2? Remember, this should go to 2. Y should always go to 2 as x tends to 1. You cannot choose this path. You cannot choose this path because as y tends to 2, x should tends to 1. But x is tending to 0, this you cannot choose this path. Yeah, you can choose this path. What is this path? This path is y equals to 2. So as x tends to 1, it is independent of x, it is always tending to 2. You can choose this path, you can start with this path. You can start with this path, this is x equals to 1. As y tends to 2, x tends to 1, this is correct. If I am getting different answer for this two path itself, I will conclude that okay, the limit does not exist. But if I am getting the same answer, I will have to take some another line, suppose this line, but this line may not be of the form y equals to mx, it will be of the form y equals to mx plus c. You have to determine the c and so on. So got my point, what I am trying to say, don't always start with x equals to 0 and y equals to 0. Sir has told us to start always with x equals to 0 and y equals to 0. No, I did not tell you that. I told you, you start with the simplest functions that you can think of. The simplest functions are definitely the straight lines. So I started with x equals to 0, y equals to 0, but under this condition, here I cannot start with x equals to 0 and y equals to 0. Keep that in mind. So do you have any confusion up to here?